I would be devastated to know that they were in a school with an 8-year-old having a gun. I just think it's terrible. I just don't understand how it happened.
When I asked police, they told me right now they have no idea where he got the gun. These redacted court documents give us a glimpse of the child alleged to be involved. Described only as MG, a delinquent child, his birth date, a reminder of the unusual nature of the crimes which he is charged. Receiving stolen property, we now know police believe the child knew the gun was stolen. That gun, a Glock Model 43, loaded. Zetta Brown lives across the street from Cheviot School.
I mean, to think that an 8-year-old can get his hands on a gun to bring to school loaded. I mean, it's really sad.
Just last year, the superintendent declared that the district of 35,000 students is safe and secure. But clearly, something went wrong Wednesday. A loaded gun made its way into a classroom of third graders. Among the questions I asked, are all students checked by metal detectors or wands? What security is in place, and was it executed Wednesday? And will those plans change in light of a loaded pistol getting into a classroom? The district's response, CPS takes safety very seriously, which is why the superintendent created the school safety task force. We continue to gather the input of task force members to improve safety and security in our buildings. Finally, we can't discuss the district's safety protocols and procedures. But Wednesday, it was not a safe learning environment here.
I have 3 children. I have 5 grandchildren. I have this beautiful little great-grandson. And I want a better world for my family.
Now, previously, we were told by the district that all the high schools have metal detectors. All the other schools apparently have those wands that they check people with. And anyone going in and out of this building here, the school board and all the 62 buildings that they have, must have some kind of ID. Reporting live, I'm Curtis Fuller, WLWT News 5.